first caveman, Wog, accidentally killed himself by swallowing flaming fire sticks in order to amuse his fellow cave persons. People have been looking for new and ever more original ways to entertain their fellow man. And never, I repeat, never in the annals of entertainment has one man devoted himself more dutifully, studied so scrupulously, and documented so diligently these eccentric, bizarre, and astonishing feats of physical and mental derring-do than the man they call America's scholar of the unusual, magician, author, bon vivant, raconteur, prestidigitator extraordinaire, and a personal friend to whom I no longer owe a favor, Ricky Jay.
I will not waste your time this evening with kumquats, pears, or prunes. No, no, no. Ladies and gentlemen, the most prodigious of household fruits, you guessed it, the watermelon. Out of season and dreadfully expensive. Watch as I try to penetrate the juicy, rich, red interior of said melon with a perfectly placed shot from an ordinary playing card. Yats! 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 Why is he still doing this? Yats! Ladies and gentlemen, please notice that my last two shots penetrated exactly the same slit in the watermelon, a feat so impressive, I am forced to mention it myself. You're saying, sure, you're able to throw cards into the rich red interior of said melon, but can you penetrate the even thicker pachydermatous outer melon layer?
Yes!
Of course not. Who could do that? But encouraged by your approbation, I will attempt to penetrate the even thicker pachydermatous outer melon layer. Watch! Yes! This scares the melon. This wounds the melon. This ticks me off. My last card. Thank you.